Now let's examine how you would do an expression dataset, a PI calculation dataset. I'll select Tools and Datasets, and again, New PI Calculation. And what I'd like to do is a CDT 158 temperature, but in Fahrenheit. So I'll type in CDT 158 underscore F, and I'll include a description this time, CDT 158 converted to Fahrenheit. This time I need to include the entire expression as well as the tag name, so I will begin typing left paren single quote CDT 158 single quote times 9 divided by 5, and I will add 32 to that. And once I do that, it will give me the result of that calculation. Now I'd like this calculation to occur at much greater intervals, or much smaller intervals, much greater frequency than 10 minutes. So I will put in here 30 seconds. And what this will do is give me the temperature in Fahrenheit every 30 seconds. I'm going to change this column label to degrees underscore Fahrenheit, and we will click OK. And now if I use that tag in a dynamic element, that will give me the result that I'm looking for. Let's go and use the draw value function, and let's draw the PI calculation data set degrees Fahrenheit for my tag. And what we'll see is that my degrees Fahrenheit for this particular tag is 310.011, and that has a timestamp of 108.00. You will notice if we wait a few seconds and give this time to recalculate, we should see the temperature change, the reading change for this particular performance equation. And we see there that 30 seconds has gone by and we have a new value. So you can see how an expression data set can take a tag and take tag information and combine it into various ways and give you a whole different value. In another example, we can see how you can use multiple tags to report a given state of your process using the data sets. I'm going to go to Tools and Datasets and create a new PI calculation data set once again, and I'm going to call this my alarm data set. And in this case, I want to know if my CDT 158 value goes over a certain degree point and another process is inactive. Let's say maybe I go over a certain degree and my relief valve is off. So what I can do is create an expression that goes, if CDT 158, I remembered my single quotes, is greater than or equal to 150, and I have a tag here called BA colon active dot one. This tag has values of either active or inactive. I will say if that's value is inactive, then I want to produce the message warning. And if it's not, if we don't meet that criteria in any other condition, I want to report the value of normal. I'm going to evaluate for this every 15 seconds, and I am going to label the value CDT. I'm going to label the value tank 1. So it's my alarm for tank 1. And I can click OK and close. And now what I can do is go and use this in an element. I will use this in my dynamic value. I will select PI calculation instead of tag. I will select alarm and tank 1. And I will click OK, and what I will see here during run mode is that as long as my values are met, as long as my conditions met, my alarm for tank 1 is going to read normal. If I should ever go outside those values, if that CDT tag should be greater than or equal to 150 and my valve is inactive, then I will set my alarm.tank1 dataset to the word warning. So there's a lot of different ways you can use datasets. Remember the rule, create the dataset, then use it in a dynamic element.